We are at a crossroads on this planet. I'm going to show you how you can escape the abuse of the controllers. Hi, I'm Saratoga Ocean, and I work together with an interdimensional, interuniversal, and extraterrestrial force known as Telstar, along with Archangel Michael. In this video, I'm going to show you some practical steps you can take to escape the controller's abuse and continue to evolve and ascend. And I'm really excited to share this with you because I'm going to show you the main reason that we are trapped and how to start freeing yourself at the deepest, most profound level. I think by now it should be pretty obvious that something truly evil apparently has taken over our planet. So what we need to do first is to understand how we got here so we have a chance to turn things around for ourselves as individuals. So let's start by defining the problem, and then we can discuss the solution. When we look underneath all of the surface chaos, we can see that our problem is actually very simple. It can be distilled down to one word, and that word is compliance. Now, I'm going to be talking about that word at a much, much deeper level and explain to you how that is actually so deeply interwoven into this matrix that we live in. So we're not going to talk about it only at a surface level. Humanity on this Earth has probably been one of the most compliant planetary civilizations ever known in the galaxy and maybe even in the universe. And this is not really an easy thing to get out of, especially if you don't understand how deeply it reaches into our consciousness. See, it is actually a very serious problem on an evolutionary basis. In fact, it's actually the main reason that we are so slow to evolve on this planet, and also why we find it so difficult to ascend. So the first step in escaping the controller's abuse is to go beneath the chaos and examine the issue of compliance collectively and in your own life. Now, this is not as simple as saying, well, compliance just means doing what you're told. So if we stop doing what we're told, well, the problem will be solved. That might be somewhat true on a surface level, but the problem is actually deeper than that. See, first we get ourselves into a compliant situation where we can be ruled over, and then we think that the only solution is to rebel and fight back. And that cycle has continued on this planet for thousands of years. It just keeps going back and forth as to who is controlling who. Now, in the larger scheme of things, we know that this approach does not work because look at where we are today. Pretty much worse than ever before on a planetary level. So maybe fighting back can give us some breathing room and make the controller's efforts much more difficult. But it actually doesn't solve the problem in the long run because it's not a progressive solution. And as a humanity, we just continue to stay stuck in the cycle of being ruled over and then fighting to get free. But now we are at a very serious crossroads. The level of control is moving to a whole new level because of AI. I mean, think about it. This is the first time in Earth's history that humanity can be uniformly controlled on a planetary scale. So we need to begin dealing with this by shifting our consciousness to a metaphysical level and not only stay focused on the finite physical level of things. So now I'm going to share with you the most interesting thing and the basis of this whole compliance problem. See, when we incarnate here, we enter into a certain system of thought. And some might call that the matrix of thought. That system has primarily to do with identity and who you are told to be on this planet. And this is really like, almost like the kingpin in this entire weird matrix. When we incarnate here, we are actually incarnating into a preordained artificial identity. The primary identity that we incarnate into is this. Who you are is a person who needs to be told what to do. It starts at birth and it continues all the way to the end of our lives. Our entire lives are structured around this one single mandate. Religions tell us what to do, governments tell us what to do, and society tells us what to do. And this is all enforced by a system of punishment and reward. So we did not get to where we are today just in the past year and a half. Where we are now is the result of a progression that is thousands of years old. Now, if you look at where we are now on a collective basis, it's kind of clear that humanity is not evolving. And I'm not referring to those of us who are here as starseeds, wayshowers, lightworkers, and awakening humans. We're all here because of this problem, because of the problem that humanity isn't really evolving. See, we're told that all of this amazing AI technology is proof that we are evolving. It's not, because it's not natural evolution. It's not organic ascension. It's artificial, it's augmentation. And the augmentation that technology is putting on us is actually slowing down our evolution, and it's actually dumbing us down more and more and more. See, the thing is, if we had been truly evolving, we would not be in the situation we're in today. Now, the crossroads that we are at now shows that we have a very small window to completely shift how we see ourselves as individuals. We need to start evolving now. We need an absolute massive paradigm shift in terms of our own perception. See, the timeline split that we always talk about is really about choice. It starts with centering yourself and choosing as a cosmic creator. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit more about this compliance matrix in a few moments, but first I need to mention one very important thing. I like to bring up certain pitfalls that we want to be aware of so that we don't get tripped up in terms of our presence on this planet. It's so important for those of us who are awake and who are awakening and who are here to help that we don't get caught in this problem ourselves, that we don't let this whole weird situation draw us in so much that we lose our own sense of who we really are. Now, right now, many of us are playing kind of a dangerous game with ourselves. And you know, I've been watching this for a while and I'm often kind of hesitant to mention it because, well, I get sort of accused of being negative, but it's not negative at all, and I'll explain to you why. See, the dangerous game that I'm talking about is how we tend to, we're almost like gaslighting ourselves. See, we like to say things like, you know, the light is winning, or the light always wins. Now, of course, the light does always win, but you know, that we don't know what the scale of time that happens in, so that's not really the most accurate thing to be telling ourselves right now if we really want to focus on our necessary evolution. But saying that the light is winning, or how about this, the light has already won, or we've won, or we are winning. And then there's the very ancient religious idea that now gets translated in many ways into modern renditions, which is there's someone who's going to save us. Or the controllers are just doing this to us because they're scared and they know that they're losing. See, here's the thing. This is not really ultimately about the controllers. The controllers that we see and that we are aware of are just minions. This is really about AI. Let me tell you an interesting little story that I heard recently about something that happened in Japan. I think it was just a few years ago, where they were developing autonomous robots for military use. So in this one lab, I think there were four robots, and all of a sudden these autonomous robots started killing people in the lab. And I think they killed, it was either 21 people or 29 people, it was 20 something people. I don't remember the exact number. So the people in the lab managed to get control of three of them before they killed any more. And then they saw something happening with the fourth robot that was really, really creepy. The fourth robot was actually communicating with satellites to get more information on how to more effectively kill the rest of them. they got the fourth robot under control. I don't know what happened, but essentially it kind of ended at the 20-something people that were killed. So we really don't know what kind of planet AI could potentially turn this into. Because you see, every single thing the controllers are doing is all designed to lead us into this AI matrix. So in my opinion, the way that we tend to kind of spiritually gaslight ourselves really probably ought to stop. And I know we do it to make ourselves feel better, but I want to explain to you why this kind of practice can actually be dangerous. What it does is it causes us to use up precious, precious time being passive and relying on false assumptions that actually have no real evidence that they're occurring. Now, as to the idea that the light always wins, well, of course that's true, but you need to understand something else. This is not about winning and losing. And that is one of the main paradigm shifts that we really need to make. We need to get out of that whole paradigm that this is about who wins and who loses. We want to shift into a recognition that what this is really about is evolution. We need to start evolving as quickly as we possibly can. And see, that's so much better than passively waiting and assuming that it's all turning out and you don't really know, but you're just taking someone's word for it. It's so much better to focus on your own evolution, because that way you're taking real practical steps to move forward and to take responsibility for your own being in this universe. And I'm gonna talk about how to start doing that in just a moment. Now, if we just look at what's going on the surface level on this planet, all of the chaos, all of the craziness, all the division, the anger, the hatred, the fear, all of that stuff that's going on. See, there's nothing in that mix that is connecting us to the benevolent universe. All of that stuff that I just mentioned is actually connecting us to something very dark, but that's all on the surface. So what does connect us to the benevolent universe? What connects us to that benevolent, loving universe is something that exists inside of us. And I cannot emphasize that enough, because that's something inside of each one of us that connects us to that positive, beautiful, light-filled universe of love is untouchable by all of this junk, by all of this chaos. Now, I've talked about this before, but I just want to mention it again. Because a lot of people wonder, why don't the benevolent extraterrestrials come and help us? Why don't they just come here and do something about this terrible situation? See, in order to understand the answer to that question, you have to go back to what I was saying before, that the chief concern in this universe is, are we evolving? Are the conditions on planet Earth conducive to human evolution? And yes, certainly there are benevolent extraterrestrials out there, but you know, they kind of know that if they were just land here, I mean, what are they going to do? Get in a battle? Get in a war? It's not going to change our evolution at all. We're still going to be as unevolved as we are now, and maybe even more so, because we might end up being traumatized by the whole experience. I'm speaking collectively. It's ultimately not really going to solve anything. So therefore, the question is, how do we start evolving now? And this is the beautiful thing that you can focus on. Because see, all this chaos is a massive, massive distraction from that one core point. How do we start evolving now? We need to start evolving through all of this craziness, almost like how a light pierces the darkness. We need to be the light that pierces the darkness of this craziness. We need to be the light in our own lives where we just evolve right through it and we do not allow it to stop us. So here's the place to begin. We start by realizing that we need to evolve out of that core identity that we all incarnated into, which is who you are is a person who needs to do what you are told. And you will be rewarded when you do and punished when you don't. That's it. Those two sentences alone completely describe the identity that we incarnate into when we come to this planet. And this deep-seated identity is also the main reason why we find it so difficult to experience ourselves as cosmic creators. So what does this artificially induced identity do? It breeds insecurity, it breeds fear, and it breeds passivity. It does not empower us to evolve. It keeps us trapped in a system where we can be used and abused. And it also makes us very easily receptive to lies that make us feel better. So let's talk about how you can start to evolve yourself as an individual out of this false, artificially induced identity. You want to start by examining your own personal journey into this system. How has your own identity been shaped by this? You can do a life's review for yourself and take note of all the ways in which you were controlled from birth to be a person whose job it is to do what you are told. Then reflect on all of the ways that punishment and reward were used to get you to do that. Now, your parents or your caretakers, whoever they were already victims of this because they had to be compliant in how they raised you in terms of social, religious, and government norms. They were likely being scrutinized at every moment by their peers and their family members who likely judged them and pressured them to comply. And you also want to look at that very long journey through school and also in any other ways that you were told to be compliant with a religion. I mean, when you start really examining this, it can really be kind of mind-blowing. You had to be compliant in how you dressed or risk being rejected by your peers. And here's the weird thing. It's always some invisible corporate force who informs us of the latest fashion to adopt through various media outlets. It's never our own creative choice. No, it's the corporate powers behind the scenes who decide what it is that we are supposed to wear. They have to control what we buy and maintain uniformity in how we dress. And then think about your home. We move into a house and we are told what every room in that house is supposed to be used for. We're told what type of furnishings belong in each and every room. And then we're told when those furnishings are outdated and need to be replaced with the latest, most modern style. Can you imagine if everyone did exactly what they wanted with their house without any of those influences and dressed in their own highly creative individual ways? I mean, it would be fashion chaos. They wouldn't even know what to sell us anymore because we would be in control, not them. So as you look into this more and more, you can see that this compliance identity actually runs very, very deep. And then there's the subject of so-called trends. The lie is that trends are created by people. In most cases, they're actually not. They are initiated and controlled by invisible corporate interests. I mean, do you think that the trends that appear on social media are completely organic and natural? They're actually not. The corporations behind the scenes and the AI algorithms control what trends on social media and what doesn't trend. And you know, here's an interesting thought. All of us on this planet have probably endured all kinds of different traumatic experiences. You might want to ask yourself how much of your previous experiences of trauma are directly related to this compliant individual identity situation. Now, here is the most important thing to recognize about this entire idea that I'm sharing with you. A person whose core identity is that they are an individual who needs to be told what to do in order to be rewarded and avoid punishment is someone who can be easily controlled and ruled by fear. So this, my friends, is the core identity that prevents us from evolving. This is precisely what has led us into the situation that we find ourselves in today. Here's something really, really interesting. Who we are on the inside is very different from this compliant individual who has been shaped on the outside. So the key to evolving and escaping the controller's abuse is to shift our identity from this compliant person on the outside to the free cosmic creator that we are on the inside. See, here's the thing. It's only the true self who can evolve. A compliant individual has no way to evolve because they are not truly free. They are shaped entirely by someone or something outside of themselves. And this is also why I say that we have to stop gaslighting ourselves by saying things like, the more the controllers crack down on us, the more it shows that we are winning. I mean, that's like saying that the more a victim is abused by some evildoer, well, the more that victim is winning. It's like saying that the more a child is beaten and neglected by an abusive parent, the more that child is winning. See, if you believe that kind of thing, you're going to think there's nothing for you to do and that we don't need to evolve because you're going to believe it's already being taken care of. You're going to think that the abuse is a sign that everything's going great, and it's actually not. Now, once you realize that we've all incarnated into this core collective identity of being people who need to do what they're told, and you see how deep that runs in your own life, the next thing to do is to figure out how you can carve out some space for yourself that is not tied to that core identity. The best way to start is to spend some time alone getting in touch with what you really feel inside. You need to start validating yourself at the deepest possible level. And then you need to find ways to choose to be something other than a purely compliant individual. So I recommend finding some part of your life that is truly yours, some place that the controllers and even compliant family members cannot touch. It could be an hour of time that you take every day to do only what you want. Maybe it's time to learn something new. Maybe it's a creative hobby, or maybe it's just time to rest and relax because you feel that's what you need. But don't make it time when you're just plugged into the internet or watching TV, because that's really just plugging yourself into the controller's mind control devices. Let your time be organic and just for you. Time when you can start to feel whole again inside of yourself. See, the idea is not to feel like you're divided into two different people. You need to find parts of your life that you can own and that are truly yours. So this is the first step. You want to find a way that you can anchor yourself into a place that you can own, from which you can truly begin to evolve as a being. Find any and all places in your life that the controllers cannot access, and then seek to preserve those spaces. Try to make them better. Create them to be how you want them to be. And then I want to suggest that you consider these spaces to be extremely sacred. Consider them to be very precious because they are yours. Then you want to infuse those spaces with gratitude, with love, and with heartfelt appreciation. These are the areas in your life that allow you to begin escaping the controller's abuse. And this is what's going to give you strength. This is what will help keep your spirit alive so that you can evolve. And part of evolving is to come to terms with all of the ways that you have allowed yourself to be controlled. And then decide how you're going to change that and provide yourself with a different experience. And I want to give you one final tip about how you can use this idea to dramatically improve the quality of your life. This is a really interesting one. Pay attention to how much you allow your own unique patterns and habits to control you. Or how much do you allow your past to control what you are capable of in the future? Or how much do you allow negative beliefs to control what you are capable of? See, when you start to explore all of these different areas that I'm talking about, you will begin to realize that you have so many ways to evolve and escape the controller's abuse. You have so many ways that you can actually be in command and start to feel empowered in your own life. And you will begin to realize that there are many avenues inside and outside in your life where you can take back the reins of your life and stop feeling so victimized and so controlled. I think that if you try this, it will make a huge difference in your overall experience. What you will discover is that you actually have a lot of openings still available to you to evolve in so many different ways. Now, of course, there are going to be areas in your life that you can't really change because they involve an integration with society, an integration with the laws, and maybe even areas that integrate with you keeping your family intact or taking care of children or something like that. But that's okay because there are so many other areas that you can evolve in. So you really, if you really explore this, you're going to realize you already have your hands full with so many areas in which you can evolve. So the bottom line of this whole conversation is this. You are either a wholly compliant, intimidated individual, or you are a creator. Only creators can evolve because they are the only ones who have the freedom to do so. So if you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and share it out with anyone else who you think would find this information valuable. And be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell because I am here every Sunday, Tuesday, and Friday with all new videos. And with that, I'm sending you so much love, light, and high vibrational energy. And I so look forward to seeing you in the next video. Namaste.